Hello everyone, last class we are discussing the non-linear optics and harmonic generation. Next I am going to the second harmonic generation. Already we have seen that equation also for first order, second order and third harmonic generation. What is second harmonic generation means? A polarization oscillating at a frequency 2 omega radiates an electromagnetic wave of same frequency which propagates the same velocity as that of the incident wave. The wave thus produced has the same characteristics of directionality and monochromaticity as the incident wave, and this emitted in the same direction. This phenomena we know as the second harmonic generation. In most crystalline materials, the nonlinear polarizability chi square depends on the direction of propagation and polarization of the electric field and orientation of the optic axis of the crystal. Since in such crystalline materials, the vectors polarization vector P and electric field vector E are not necessarily parallel to the coefficient X and must be treated as a tensors. P and E are tensors. Therefore, the second order polarization we can be written as P square is equal to epsilon naught summation of J into chi ij ej plus summation of jk into chi ij k into ej ek plus triple summation or summation of JKL log chi IJKL and EJ EKEL and so on. We go for higher orders. Next, and also I am written as this P square is equal to epsilon naught chi power 1 into E general log badidini D chi square E A cube like that, where chi power 1 is a second order rank tensor. It describes the linear optics or linear effect, and chi square is a third order rank tensor. It describes the lowest non-linear effect, and chi cube is the fourth rank tensor. It describes the next higher order non-linear effects and so on, where I, J, K represent the coordinates of X, Y, Z. The most of the coefficients of chi I, J, K, however, are as usual zero, and we have to deal only with one or two components. That's why I am written as this dipole vector or a polarization vector is P square is equal to epsilon naught sigma ijk chi ijk square for second order ej ek. In must mentioned here that the second order harmonic generation represented by occurring only in certain type of crystals. For example, I am taken here a crystal as isotropy. That means all the properties are same in all direction for that crystalline. In this case, chi ijk is independent of direction and hence it is a constant. If now in reverse condition, that means the reverse the direction of the axis, x tends to minus x, y tends to minus y and z tends to minus z, leaving the electric field and dipole moment unchanged in this direction, the sign of these two must be changed. That is minus pi square is equal to epsilon naught summation of jk chi ijk square. Electric field means minus Ej minus Ek, then its dipole moment is unchanged, that's why that is plus Pi square, which means that Pi square is equal to 0, then this whole term also equal to 0, then the second order harmonic generation therefore cannot be occur in an isotropic medium such as liquids or gases or nor in centrosymmetric crystal. That means centrosymmetric crystal means the crystal symmetrical about a point. Only in crystals that lack of inversion symmetry, they exhibit the simple harmonic generation. In the case of non-centrosymmetric materials, that is in anisotropic crystals, both quadratic and cubic terms are present. For this type of material, quadratic and cubic terms are present. However, generally, the cubic term is substantially smaller than the second order term and may be ignored. That's why I am written as first and second order equation. Such materials we can write P is equal to epsilon naught chi power 1 into E plus epsilon naught chi square E square, and medium is said to have a second order linearity. Up to here the second order harmonic generation. Next time we go to the phase matching in the second order harmonic generation. That means consider the second order generation harmonic generation. The process, the energy conservation requires, that means in terms of omega I am written as, I am considered these two photons with the incident frequencies omega. We pass it through a linear medium material or linear non-linear material. We will get one photon Here I am giving two photons, we will get one photon that is a different character. It is a red color, it is a blue color, like that. Omega, each one frequency is omega, but I am getting 2 omega for this one photon. Similarly, for the conservation of momentum, which I take k of omega in terms of wave vectors, two photons of these two vectors, I get one wave vector for another photon, that frequency is 2 omega. In terms of refractive index, you can write n of omega into omega by c or n of omega, like that. That is n of 2 omega is equal to n of omega. Then what is the importance of this phase matching? That is what we have to see. And also we are shown by the birepringent material. When we get the two rays, those two rays have different refractive indexes in birepringence or double refraction. Ordinary ray and extraordinary ray, those two have different refractive index. Then I am seeing here the ordinary ray is 2 omega and extraordinary ray is omega omega. Like that. What is the importance of phase matching is phase relation between the fundamental and generated harmonics. We incident the fundamental, we will get the generated harmonics when we pass through nonlinear material. And also the efficiency of harmonic generation, the output radiate agirutada, that is the general harmonic, that one generation is depends not only the intensity and also the direction of propagation. Then here I am explaining the phase matching. How it is a one slab of length is dz, but total length of this slab is l. Within this portion I am taken as a dz. I am incident omega 1 k 1 for this slab, and I am getting omega 1 k 1 and 2 omega 1 k 2. The second harmonic wave propagation through a material of length l. Suppose a plane wave of frequency omega and second order wave at frequency 2 omega, second harmonic one, and driven by or propagating in z direction through a material of length l. Let us find the expression for the intensity of second order harmonic generation, second harmonic generation at the exist surface of the material. This is the exist surface. What is the intensity of this surface? We have to find out. The dipole moment per unit volume induced at the frequency 2 omega, that is P2 square, which is in turn is proportional to the square of the electric field. That is ES, we can return as dEz whole square is proportional to P square z dz, and also which is proportional to exponential of 2i k1z minus omega 1t into dz. That is E is equal to, already we know that, exponential of I k1z minus omega t in terms of 2i k1z minus omega into dz for second harmonic, where dz square is an amount of second harmonic radiation within the slab. We see that the spatial variation of the second harmonic polarization is characterized by a wave number 2k1. The second harmonic radiation produced by in this slab at the exist surface of a crystal is at z is equal to l. Obviously we can return as this proportionality dEl square, when z is equal to l, dEl square proportional to dEz square in exponential of pi k2 into l minus z into z, where l minus z is the distance from slab to end. This is slab to end, that is l minus z from the slab end of the crystal, and k2 is the propagation wave vector. K2 is the propagation wave vector for second harmonic generation. In general, I am taken k2 is not equal to k1 because of the dispersion. dEl square is proportional to exponential of 2i into k1z minus omega t into exponential of I k2 l minus z into dz. I am expanded this term e power into e power minus 2z to omega t e power I k z into e power minus, like that. I won't take z terms for the same exponential term e power 2k1 minus k2 into z into e power k2 l minus 2 omega t into dz, and integrate. What I am getting, el square is proportional to 0 to l e power I into 2 k1 minus k2 into z e power I into k2 l minus 2 omega t into kz. Then by applying this is a constant term, on this one I am integrated e power x by x, like that. Applying the limits 0 to l, I am getting, and some manipulations I'm getting in terms of sine of 2k1 minus k2 into L divided by 2k1 minus k2 by 2, where we take only the real part of the proportionality factor. Then we will, when this will maximum means 2k1 minus k2 into L divided by 2 value is 5 by 2. That is the field of this second harmonic generation. Then what I am taken here, these two equations, 2 to k cancel, L is equal to 5 divided by 2k1 minus k2. Then I am substituted k is equal to 2a pi n divided by lambda. For second one, k2 is equal to 2 times of k1, that's why 4 pi n 2 omega divided by lambda. And L we get lambda divided by 4 n omega minus n 2 omega, where L is called coherence length of the second harmonic generation. Coherence length of the second harmonic generation. By increasing L beyond the above value, and we will get results in the increase in E square. The expression for intensity is, we can write as I is proportional to sine square of 2k1 minus k2 by 2 into L divided by 2k1 minus k2 by 2 whole square, where it is sharply peak out when this value equal to 0, that is 2k1 minus k2 into 2 into L is equal to 0. When this value is equal to 0, when k1 2 is equal to 2k1, then only we get 0, that is when k2 is equal to k1. For the efficient frequency is doubling, that means frequency is doubling, this relation must be satisfied. This requirement we known as phase matching criterion. Then since k2 is equal to, what we will write in terms of our refractive index, 2 omega n 2 omega by c, and k1 is equal to n omega by c, and k2 is equal to k1, which is reduces to n 2 omega is equal to n omega. Thank you for watching.